I join my colleagues in thanking China for the excellent arrangements. Your Majesty, Excellencies, the depth and breadth of the 30-year partnership between ASEAN and China were achieved by incremental steps marked by significant milestones along the way, such as today. Certainly, China deserves its status as ASEAN's comprehensive strategic partner. When the COVID-19 pandemic broke out, China was the first dialogue partner that ASEAN engaged. When the vaccines were scarce, China was among the first to provide. I am pleased that cooperative projects on preventing and controlling pandemics, sharing the best practices and technical assistance are underway. Together, we're making headway in pandemic control, allowing us to reopen our economies and go full speed with recovery effort. Enhanced multilateralism and connectivity will be the drivers of inclusive and comprehensive recovery. We thus welcome China's ratification of the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement. We also look forward to further strengthening the already robust ASEAN-China economic relations. Your Majesty, Excellencies, climate change has rightly risen to the top of our agenda. Developing coastal states like the Philippines contribute the least to global warming, but we bear the brunt of the adverse effects of climate change. The 26th UN Climate Change Conference of the Parties, or COP26, has just been wrapped up. We hope that urgent climate actions anchored on the principles of justice and fairness will follow suit. Our people depend on oceans and the seas for livelihood. Let us protect and preserve the biodiversity and the marine environment for sustained cooperation. This includes support for the work of the ASEAN Center of Biodiversity hosted by the Philippines. Your Majesty, Excellencies, we are friends and close neighbors. Our destinies are tied to each other, and geography has made it irrevocably so. Allow me then to speak with candor. The South China Sea, a strategic challenge that cannot be solved by force. We all want to benefit from the bounties of the vital maritime domain. We agree that peace and stability are a precondition for this to happen. And we all pledge adherence to the rule of law, including the 1982 United Nations Conventions on the Law of the Sea. Let us then walk our talk and move forward, acta non verba, which means deeds, not words. Let us exercise utmost restraint and avoid escalation of tension. And most importantly, let us earnestly work towards the peaceful resolution of disputes in accordance with international law. We abhor the recent event in the Ayungin Shoal and view with grave concern other similar development. This does not speak well of the relations between our nations and partnership. UNCLOS and the 2016 Arbitral Award provide legal clarity for all countries that subscribe to the majesty of the law. These two landmark documents are beacons pointing to us a just and fair solution of our disputes. We must realize these legal tools to ensure that South China Sea remains a sea of peace, stability, and prosperity. That is why China must remain committed to the early conclusion of the effective and substantive code of conduct in the South China Sea. This is simply no other way out of this colossal problem but the rule of law. Your Majesty, Excellencies, pearls come to mind when you celebrate the 30-year-old anniversaries. These gems of sea symbolizes wisdom and serenity. Amidst the shift and challenges in our region, may we always have the wisdom and serenity to do the right thing for the common good. Thank you.